Well, they're apples, and this apple over here has seen certainly better days. It's all brown and soft, but I can still eat it. And then there are also other cases where apples turn brown and you really should not eat them at all. So in this video, I want to talk about both of these situations, and I also want to give you a little bit of advice and also some information, because in which cases can you still eat a brown spot and in which cases you really can't, and maybe it's better to completely throw away the apple as it is. So hi, hello, and welcome again. Microbehunter here. I'm Oliver. And apples can turn brown for two different reasons. The first reason is browning due to so-called cell damage. If an apple falls from the tree, or if you squeeze it, or if it gets bumped during transport, then the cells inside the apple, they break. And when this happens, then a chemical reaction starts. It's an oxidation process. And this turns the damaged part brown and gives you those brown spots. The apple that you saw before, well, that one was completely brown, and I actually kept it in the freezer overnight. So freezing water inside the cells expanded, it broke the cells open, and it triggered this oxidation process, and basically almost all of the apple cells were affected. But the apple itself was not really spoiled. I could still eat it, and it tasted just normal. It just didn't look very nice anymore, but it was still edible. So that's the harmless case, and for this reason, you should always be a little bit careful when you are picking up or checking apples. Don't press them too much, because as soon as you start squeezing the apple, then some cells will break open, and then the air inside the apple, there are some air spaces, they will start to react, and then the whole browning reaction starts. But as I said, nothing to worry about. Doesn't look very nice, but you can still eat it. Now, there is also a more serious case, and this is when fungi starts to grow and break down the apple. And in this case, the brown area looks different. It's not just dry and brown, and it often looks slimy. It's softer, sometimes also a little bit wet, and you might even see some of the fungal growth on the surface. So these are the hyphae, these are thread-like cells of the fungus. And if you see this kind of rotting, then you simply cutting away the brown part is not gonna do it. It's not enough, right? In this situation, you should throw away the whole apple. Now, the reason is that the fungal cells, they grow into the apple tissue. They can be already present also in areas where the apple still looks normal from the outside. And there is also a second problem, and it's because some of these fungi produce toxins, so-called mycotoxins, which can spread far beyond the visible rotten area. And so if you cut away the brown spot, you're not removing the toxins. Some of them can actually also make you quite ill, and they might have already spread throughout the whole fruit. And especially if there's a small cut in the skin of the apple, then this can be an entry point for fungal spores. So always make sure that the apple remains intact. So my recommendation is if there are visible fungus or mold involved, throw away the entire apple as it is. Don't just cut off a bad part. And a common toxin that can be found in moldy apples is called Patulin. And in fruit juices and other apple products, the level of Patulin is actually monitored by food safety authorities to make sure it does not exceed a certain critical value. So this is the real issue. And of course, there are also other mycotoxins that you don't want to ingest in large amounts. You don't want to eat a mushroom, which you do not know what toxin it produces. And of course, therefore, you also do not want to eat any mold. Now, of course, I also put this under the microscope, and if you take the moldy part of an apple and look at it under the microscope, then you can clearly see those long thread-like cells. These are the fungal hyphae, and these are the structures that spread throughout the apple and produce the toxins. So those long thread-like structures, that's the fungus itself, it's not the apple. Well, and in contrast, when I put a small piece of the bruised apple under the microscope, then the cells still looked round and mostly intact. I was not able to see any fungal cells or other microorganisms like bacteria in the sample. So visually under the microscope, you can also see this difference between simple oxidation due to cell damage and also real microbial spoilage. And of course, many of you do not have a microscope probably at home, but do not worry, because you're still able to see a difference simply by looking if the skin of the apple is intact, and also by looking a little bit on how the actual brown spot looks like. Is it localized just on the surface a little bit of the apple? Then maybe it is due to pressure, or is it actually growing and spreading? And also, does it smell a little bit bad? That would be a sure sign of microbial spoilage. Just wanted to share this with you. Hope that you found the video interesting. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. Hope to see you again in the next video. Bye bye.